In this video, I discuss advantages and disadvantages of closed cycle gas turbine power plant over a open cycle gas turbine power plant. So first we discuss the advantages of closed cycle over a open cycle. So here it is the image of closed cycle gas turbine power plant. So first advantage is, in the closed cycle gas turbine, the working medium is heated externally. Externally means here you see in this heater, the working medium coming from the compressor is passed from this tube, and outside the tube the combustion of the fuel is carried out. So it is called as the heated externally, means fuel does not mix with it, means the fuel and the working substance are not mixed, because the working substance is passed from this tube and the fuel is outside the tube, so they are not mixed with each other. Hence, any inexpensive solid fuel such as coal can be used to heat the working fuel. Means we are able to use any type of the inexpensive solid fuel such as coal. Also, need of filtration of the incoming air is completely eliminated. So in a open cycle gas turbine power plant, we need to install the filter at the inlet of these compressors. But here it is the closed cycle. Okay, that's why this filtration is not required in the closed cycle compared to the open cycle. Second advantage, they are kept free from the product of combustion. So why they are free from the product of combustion? Because there is a indirect heating are going on, because this working fluid is passing inside this tube of the heater and the fluid is outside, means the product of combustion are not mixed with the working fluid. Hence, absence of corrosions and abrasions of the interior of turbines and the compressor extend the life of the plant and maintain the efficiency of the plant constant throughout its life. In open cycle, what happens, the combustion product is supplied into this turbine. Okay, so in a turbine blade there is a chances of corrosions and abrasions are there, but in a closed cycles we are not supplying the product of combustion into this gas turbine, so there is a absence of corrosions and abrasions are there. And when the corrosions and abrasions are not there, so efficiency of the plant is maintained constant throughout the life, and this maintenance are also required less. Third advantage, the working medium is at relatively high internal pressure, so specific volume is less. So at the inlet of this compressor, the pressure is above atmospheres. Okay, in open cycle these pressures are atmosphere, but here these pressure are not atmosphere, means that is a higher pressure are there, and when this higher pressure are there, the specific volume is less. And when the specific volume is less, then the dimensions of the compressors and turbines can be reduced and the maximum unit capacity can be increased. So size of this compressor and turbines are reduced and the capacity can be increased due to this high internal pressure. Next advantage, the working medium such as helium, argon, hydrogen, neon may be used, which has very good physical properties compared to air. Okay, so this working medium is not only use air here, but we are able to use helium, argon, hydrogen, neon. Okay, depending on the size of the plant. Okay, so we are able to use the other working fluid than the air. Okay, for examples, thermal conductivity of hydrogen is about 6.8 times that of air, and therefore requires smaller heat exchangers. Okay, so this heat transfer means thermal conductivity higher, means they are transferring the more heat, means that they are transferring more heat compared to that, that is a 6.8 times. So smaller size of these heat exchangers are required. Next advantage, the closed cycle can be operate with highest efficiency in comparison to open cycle plant at an equal initial pressure of working fluids. Means we are maintain the equal initial temperature of the working fluid, means these T1 are same for the open cycles and for the closed cycles. Okay, and this closed cycle is give you the highest efficiency. The power output at the constant speed can be vary, means power output from these generators can be vary So how we can vary this power output? By adding or subtracting the mass of working fluid and thus altering the weight of the charge, and this gives improved part load efficiency as compared to the open cycle gas turbine. Means part load efficiency is higher compared to the open cycle. So this, how these adding and subtracting of the mass of working fluids are there. So that is a some provisional are provided, from that we can add the working fluids or we can remove the working fluid. Means we are not discussing about the burning of fuel here, we are discussing about the what the fluid, working fluid pass from these all these components. Okay, it is called as the working fluids. So that is a difference between that, that is the fuels and fluids. Another advantage, high heat transfer can be possible. So heat transfer rate is higher compared to these open cycles. The maintenance cost is low compared to the open cycle. Reliability is high compared to the open cycle. Life of the plant is more compared to the open cycles. Okay, so these are the various advantages of closed cycles over a open cycles. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to power plant engineering and other subject of this mechanical engineering. For more video, I request to visit the playlist of my channels for power plant engineering, various link is provided in descriptions as well as in the card. Now next topic is the disadvantages of closed cycles. So first disadvantage, in a closed cycle gas turbine, considerable quantity of cooling water is required. Okay, so here you see, in this cooler we are required a cooling water. So cooling water in and this cooling water are out. So why this cooling water is required? To absorb the heat energy from the working fluid. Okay, so due to this water requirement, this closed cycle gas turbine are not used in a aircraft. Okay, means in aviation industries we only need to use the open cycle gas turbines. Second disadvantage, heat addition to the working medium takes place through heat exchanger, hence full heat of the fuel fire is not utilized. So we are also discussed that, that is a indirect heating are going on, means working fluid is passed inside the tubes and the fuel combustion of the fuel is carried out outside the tube. Okay, means it is called as the indirect heat exchangers. Okay, due to that reasons the full heat of the fuel fire is not utilized, means by burning the fuel some heat energy are produced, so these full heat energies are not utilized. Another disadvantage, additional equipment such as externally fire heaters, cooler are required, and the plant and its operations make additional complexity. Okay, so we know that compared to the open cycle, here the externally fire heaters are added, cooler are added. Okay, so due to these two components, the plant and its operations make the additional complexity. The closed cycle gas turbine will be preferable over a open cycle, one only when inferior type of fuels or a solid fuel is to be used and the cooling water is at the side is available. Means the closed cycle gas turbine is preferable, means we can use the closed cycle on such a places over a open cycle when the inferior type of the fuel is available or solid fluid is to be used and the cooling water at the side is available. So we are required three things to use the closed cycle compared to the open cycle: inferior type of the fuel, solid fuels, and the cooling water is available. At that time we are able to use the closed cycle gas turbine power plant. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video and subscribe my channel for watching this more video, and don't forget to share with your friends.